on, give me something. Just bones. Darn. Alright, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go one more time. As you can see, I'm standing over here by the tree farm. It's been put up and tore down a few times. I've been collecting my wood for the coal factory and all that. I've been trading off with the villagers. It's basically what I've been spending a lot of my time doing. Just cycling through the different farms, trading with the villagers, banking my emeralds, trying to get them up into some decent trades so that I can have the gear I want. I did get around to building a fairly decent wheat farm. I found those little plots in the village were just ineffective. So I snapped the design off of the YouTube tutorials, and it's pretty simple. Basically, these dispensers have water buckets all the way along. Once the wheat's fully grown, you punch the button, it all gets swept down, carried over to the little collection pool here. Not that complicated, pretty simple concept. I could have done the bone meal, you know, the roll where you run back and forth or use a minecart, go back and forth, but I'm really not in that big of a hurry. I let the thing mature naturally and come by every once in a while and just punch the button, let it fill, let them all flood away. I do want to build a dome around this, though. I keep finding I have to stop and walk around, and I've been getting mobs come through trampling my crops. And actually, it's funny, those insects you see buzzing around here a lot from mo creatures, they can actually pop these off. If they land, they disrupt the soil, turn it back into natural dirt blocks. So I have to come back and I, you know, retill it, replant it. Even when a butterfly or a dragonfly buzzes by and lands, it's kind of annoying. So I'm going to track down some glass because I want to make a nice big greenhouse building, all glass with maybe some wood frame or something. Try and find some really nice, something different, something that's not here. This cherry blossom tree, I found that on one of my wanderings. I planted it over here just as kind of a feature, something different, but I wouldn't mind using maybe some of that wood, make it something stand out really different. I'd have to go back and find where I got this from. It was a little like a cherry blossom grove or something. So that's kind of what I was doing while I've been away. It's been busy. You know, my life's been kind of busy the past couple of days, couple of weeks really. So I haven't been around much. I know. We'll see if I can change that. If not, I might be an infrequent visitor here, but we'll see. I did get a new trader. Which one is he? I believe this guy here. No. What is it? Here. I've got a wool. Somebody who wants wool now. Originally here was my diamond axe seller. He had, I believe, the chainmail chest plate afterward. Never got around to buying that. But I did come over this guy here. Yeah, the diamond hoe. He has the chest plate. I did buy the chest plate. And lo and behold, afterward came up the diamond axe. It's actually cheaper, 9. The guy who was here originally was asking 10. So he had to go. He just wasn't worth keeping around. I can get it from him cheaper, and I didn't need to buy the diamond or the chainmail chest plate to see what he had even further down. So now I've got somebody who buys wool. My next step will be to put in a wool farm. I've already collected some. Nice thing about colored wool, I don't even really have to worry about it. Because if I need to, I can convert it to string and magically convert it back to white wool. That's how you bleach wool in this. I believe that's, again, improving Minecraft mod, allows me to convert it to string and back into wool. Just takes the color out of it. So, yeah, there's a couple of simple ideas you can do for a wool farm. Doesn't have to be overly complicated. I could just get a big pen full of wool, of sheep, square them off into here, because I'm not butchering them. I don't have to hunt them down and make a fancy way of killing them. I could just go in there with a pair of shears and clean them all up like I do over at the cabin in the woods. But, you know, everything else has a touch of redstone or a touch of creativity to it. You know, this one's got the piston crusher. This one's got the egg spitter. This one's pretty straightforward, though. They breed, they float down, they drowned. I didn't have to get too complicated with the cow farm. But I have seen some designs for the sheep farm that I think I'm going to incorporate here. I've got nice space right here. It doesn't have to be very big. So I will go and gather the materials, and we'll get that out of the way. Alright, so to make room for the wool farm, I decided to push this wall back. It was useless space anyway. It was just empty space on the inside. So I just pushed it back. Made some more room on the exterior here. So I went and laid out the first, but I've run into a bit of a problem. If I place the leaves there, and I fire the pistons actually break the leaves. They don't drop anything, they just disappear. So I can't use leaves on the sticky pistons, because apparently they don't push leaves, they just break them. So I'm going to have to get glass or glowstone or something to put in there, probably glowstone. It's probably easier to find glowstone than sand right now. I'm still looking for that desert. I did take some time and wander in a couple of directions, but I didn't go very far. When I was looking for the desert when I made the jail, I never did come across one. So I scrapped the idea of using the cactus to break the mines, or the mine carts, I should say. So I'm going to have to find something. I can duck down to the nether, grab some glowstone. It'll keep the place lit up, keep mobs from spawning inside of it as well, so that'll help. They recommended using glowstone in the wheat farm too, just to keep it growing overnight. I have torches at the moment, but glowstone might help too, so maybe I'll do a quick journey to the nether, gather up some glowstone, and get this going. I didn't anticipate this problem. I thought the wheat, or the, I keep wanting to call it wheat, the leaves would work nicely, but since they're not pushable by the pistons, I'm going to have to go to a different plan. So off we go. I'll be right back. Alright, let's see how that works now. Let's get them all lined up. There we go. That's the idea. Now I'm going to mirror that on this side. I'm going to wire them all up to one button so that I can run down, do the shearing, push the button. They all come together in the middle. And then I can just walk back and get all the wool. Maybe I should put the button on this side. Shear all the way down, push the button, collect all the way back. That makes sense. Okay, I'm going to wire it that way, actually. So I'll steal you. And you don't need it anymore. Notice my shiny, sparkly pickaxe there? I know it's an iron pickaxe, but I couldn't resist. The auto-smelting is really nice. It works basically like Silk Touch, but it picks up and it automatically converts anything into its smelted form. So down in the nether, I ended up with some nether bricks instead of netherrack, but the efficiency, unbreaking, and fortune were just too hard to pass up. I'm still debating on making a diamond pickaxe. I probably should have, but iron is good for now. It's easy to repair. Until it gets too expensive to repair, I'll probably just process on this one. And we'll go from there. So basically this is where I've been getting my sand from. And as you can see, I have a bit of a finite resource on my hands here. There is some out here, but trying to get it under the water here is a bit of a pain. And yeah, it does extend out there. I could go swimming and collect all the sand under there, but I don't have any aqua affinity right now, and it's really hard to get down there to dig up the sand. So I've just been kind of pulling it off the beach here, and eventually I'm going to run out, probably rather quickly I'm going to run out here. And this is what I've been converting for my glass usage. I really need to go find a desert that I can just start pulling apart and go from there, because this is running out quickly. So I'm going to use some glass from this to finish the sheep pen. And then we're going to go collect some sheep and start breeding them. I'm going to make room for 12. I think 12 is a good number. I got 6 on each side. And then from there, we will try and finish the greenhouse. And then I got a couple other ideas just to round out the episode. And yeah, see, I'm getting close to the water there already. I'm a little leery of breaking too much down. I don't want to flood myself here. So from there, we'll go. Alright, so building that wool farm, I realized I ran out of redstone. Like, literally, right dead out of redstone. And so I've come down to my mine, started digging into the ground here. See, we're down in the mine again. And I was just plowing through, using the looting 3 to its best effect. And the auto-smelting, as you can see. And I punched a hole, and I got shiny blue. And there's some emerald down there, too, but I'm waiting. Should I wait and get a silk touch and gather them up, or should I just pop them right now and collect them? I mean, it doesn't matter. I've already got fortune 3. So I'm not going to get any better. So I might as well go ahead and grab them. What do I get for emeralds? Aww, still only one emerald. How weak was that? Looting 3, or Fortune 3, and I get one emerald. See if the diamond's better. Ooh! 4. 5, 6. 9. 12. 12 from 4. That's pretty good. I don't mind that. See if there's any more hidden in the walls. Usually they're touching, so if you get to that point, you don't usually find more, but let's see. And no, looks like that was it. Still, 12 shiny. That emerald was kind of disappointing. There are a couple of other emeralds down here, though, that I've been waiting for a fortune 3. Maybe I should go pop them right now, too. Right there. So what do we get out of him? Just another one. Does fortune 3 not work on the emerald blocks? Two more. Ah, there we go. That's a better result. Got 5 off of those 2. Oh, that's right, up here. Okay. Ah, that Fortune 3 is not impressing me when it comes to emeralds. And 1 again. And 1 again. I'm very disappointed. Diamonds works great. Coal, redstone, wonderful. Emeralds, not so much. I'll have to remember that. Alright, back in the village. Just going to make my deposits. See, I have been trading. I've been very busy with my emeralds. Diamonds, these are from when we went to the nether. Some of them anyways. Because I got my diamond horse armor down here as well. Then I've just been collecting all the random peridot and amber and such. I've got some of that back at the cabin in the woods. I've got a couple others I could probably bring over here, but yeah, make my bank deposit for the day. And the poor old teller, he's still wandering back there. Guy never gets a break. Right now, I'm having a bit of problem with the redstone, because if I push the button, it doesn't reach. See, it only goes about a little ways. So, come back around here, finish up the wiring, all that fun stuff. And that's that. I just push the button here. Bang. They all come out, they all go in. Just like that. All it took was the two repeaters to extend it all the way down. Now I'll build another structure around it, put the roof on, and, well, I should probably put the sheep in here first. That's why I left these cavities open here. Oh, I gotta close off these backs too here. What should I put? Oh, I got, you know what, no one's gonna see the stone anyways. I'll just put the stone back there. 2, 3, 4, 5 there. Yeah, you know, I kinda wish I had moved this over like 3 blocks. No, not worth it. Too much effort, too much time. I'll just knock this fence back instead. It's probably easier. So, how's my wheat farm? Looks like it's 100%. Let's take a quick stroll here. Is it all done? I don't want to drop off the edge. Yeah, okay, quick demo. This is... Oop. Punch it. I gotta finish, like I said, greenhouse over here to cover all this redstone. Flow down. I also put something along here to keep the wheat from sitting on the edge. See, you got them sitting here. So, I'm gonna incorporate that into here so that all I have to do is come down here and collect the end result. Of course, I have to be able to get in here to reseed, but that's not hard. Oh, there's more over here. The excess seed I tend to feed to my chickens that are up there. I'm going to end up with like 250, 300 chickens up there just spitting out eggs. And then I'll have chicken galore. So, whoa, trapped in the water. Now I just shut her off. Pop that again. Away they go. And... Oh, see, some of it got off the edge too. Now watch this fly. Is he going to bother me? Don't land on my dirt. Oh, he didn't do it that time. I've watched dragonflies do it. The firefly didn't do it. Good. Pop. So what's my end result? 48. 2 stacks and 48. That's a lot of wool. A lot of wheat. Lot of wheat. So, good. Alright, there we have it. I had to do some rearranging because I was kind of foolish. I put the pistons behind the wrong glowstone, so I was actually pushing these front ones forward rather than these back ones. So it really didn't do anything to help. But I had to make the building just one block wider on each side in order to accommodate the new piston line, and it works pretty good. I am having trouble over in this corner though. For some reason, these three, this one back, and that one back, don't retract after they've been fired. So if I come over here, I'll show you real quick. Push the button, see they all push forward like they're supposed to. But this one, and that one do not retract. And I don't know why. They're not getting any other redstone signal anywhere else, but for some reason those three don't retract, but they will update and retract when I break the redstone, or if I break a block or something. So for some reason, and I haven't figured out why, so I'm not going to use them for now until I figure out, or someone can give me a hint as to what's going wrong with these ones. The ones that are mirrored over here, and I'm sure I built... Okay, how quickly can I do this? I have to be able to break this block and then get on top of it and not... Ah, there we go. You weren't watching, were you? Anyways, these ones retracted just fine, see? And I mirrored the build, so there should be no difference between this side and that side, but the redstone signal makes it all the way down to here, fires all of them, retracts all of them. Makes it all the way down to there, and then fires them all, but doesn't retract the last three. I don't know what the difference is. The repeater, I did move the repeater a little bit to accommodate the extra space. I could maybe try moving it forward a little bit more. Maybe put it... where's my redstone? There. This is one that fires, so I can't put it there. Let's put it here. Let's take the repeater. Oh, again? Alright. Let's try if we can get 2 for 2. Yeah, 2 for 2. Okay. Let's go there. You know what? I'm going to crouch while I do this. That might be the smart thing to do. And there. Okay, so I know the redstone signal will make it this far. And let's see if that helps. And I didn't crouch that time. Yeah, my one brown sheep, I found him out wandering. Brought him back because I thought maybe something a little different. All of these guys I bred from the ones that I had collected over there. And then my wanderings, I found a brown sheep, so I thought I'd bring him back. Just for a little variety. So does that help? Oh, I guess I should put my redstone back. Here. Nope, they're still pushed forward. That one, and that one are still pushed forward, but that one, and that one are not. Alright, enough with this. I've wasted enough time as it is. This was supposed to be a simple project. And as you guys know, my simple projects are never simple. Because I'm just, you know, not that good at them, apparently. Oh, where did it go? Alright, enough of this foolishness. I'll put a roof on it later. For now, for now we're done. I went ahead and made myself a diamond pickaxe, and I'm going to enchant it. As you can see, I did find a nice, beautiful black skeleton skull. That was just kind of a random kill on my path between the mine and the village one time. I just happened to smack him around a little bit. Waiting for a couple more. I've actually never fought a wither. The whole time I've been playing Minecraft, the whole game, for since I don't even remember when. I think I started back in 1.6. I've never fought a wither. Just never got around to it. I usually play in survival mode, and I've just never been able to collect enough skulls to fight a wither. It's just something I never did. So it is something on my list of things to do for this series. I have to be able to fight a wither and start making those beacons that everybody seems to enjoy. And, you know, at some point it's going to have to be done. So I've got my first skull, just to see. But anyways, like I said, I've got a diamond pickaxe here. I've got 32 levels. So let's see what we can roll. I want something, you know, similar to this. I actually want silk touch. I need a silk touch. So that's what I'm rolling for. That's not bad. But we're waiting for a silk touch to appear. Hopefully, oh, see, and just silk touch though. I don't want just silk touch. That would be a waste. So, ooh. I still really want the silk touch though. That is a really nice pick. I'm breaking fortune efficiency. It would replace this one because this is getting a little low. But I can always rebuild this one. Just silk touch. Oh, efficiency. Okay, efficiency for silk touch. I'd prefer to have unbreaking. Ah, here we go. Perfect. Sold. Unbreaking silk touch efficiency 4. That's what I was waiting for. Aren't we glad we held out? Just that one more roll. I almost took that previous one. I almost did, but it's a good thing I rolled one more. Okay, so we're good. 2 levels left. Not worth spending. Climbing up out of the hole here. Okay, my next idea is... Oh, I think I just heard a wolf howl. Anyways, my next idea is to get out of here. Let's sleep real quick. Yeah, that is a wolf. Oh, there he is. Oh, it's just a wolf, though, not a werewolf. So I can kill him. I hate killing wolves. I actually really like wolves. They're one of my favorite animals. Actually, they are my favorite animal. And it bugs me that I have to kill them in this game. But I don't know. They're just... Those are evil, mean wolves. They're not good wolves. So I guess I can live with that. Oh, is that a void? Oh, another one? Okay, I'll let him live. This void isn't interfering with me. Oh. Oh, he's actually trapped in there. There he is right there. There's the wolf that's howling. He's trapped in the void. Sorry, buddy. I'm kind of stuck there. I can't do anything about it. Oh, but he can attack me. Are you coming out of it? Oh, he did come out of it. Wow. He managed to fight his way out of the void. Ah, he still died, though. Alright, what was I saying? Oh, right. I'm going to go tame a horse. That's something I haven't done yet. And I might get a couple, start breeding them, see if I can get a really good horse. I know there's a racetrack you can set up to test their speed with the damage indicators or the heads-up display, whichever one I have. It actually shows me their health, so I don't have to take a guess at their health. There's my saddle. And the fur, go away, leaves, whatever, bones, that hoe, oops, get hung up, don't really need to carry around an extra shovel, but whatever, and I might as well hang the shears up as well, because I'm not dealing with the sheep right now. But okay, I know that according to my map, there was a horse nearby. Where is he? Of course, he's probably wandered off. I think there's one somewhere between me and the jail, so let's go track down a horse and ride him for a bit. See, he must have been just outside my radius, because he's right there on the map. And this is a nice, beautiful black horse. He's only got 20 health, though. But let's see how he is. Oh, right, I gotta ride him first before I can put a saddle on. Almost got him. Come on. Come on. There we go. See? Cheers. Okay, let's throw the saddle on him so that we can tell him where to go. Yeah, at least 2.5, maybe even 3. I'll have to get a jumping wall set up to test them. I know they go up by 1/8 of a block, because I've seen an etho was doing his jumping test, he used layers of snow to get them up. So maybe, oh, here's a plus two. Let's see. Oh yeah, definitely two. At least two there. What else we have that's nearby? Ow. Took a branch to my eye. Okay. So we got one horse anyway. I could build one of the piston stables up here, so that when you mount them, the door opens, and when you dismount them, the door closes. Again, I think that's an Etho design. The guy's a real inspiration to me. I really have enjoyed his Let's Play series. He does such an amazing job on his redstone. I can't say enough about him. So let me go. I gotta put a lead together for this guy so that I can tether him. So let's go do that real quick. Boy, am I ever glad I can trade for saddles. Look at how expensive those are. Yikes. Alright, so I made myself the lead, and I also decided to punch out a name tag, because we got to give our horse a name. Now, I looked up some Norse mythology, because that's kind of the thing I like. I'm kind of into mythology, Norse specifically. And I found a couple of really cool names. Let's see if the copy and paste worked here properly. Put that one in there. Rid of all of this. Oh, I might not have enough here. Oh, see, it did work, but I don't have enough levels. So I'm going to have to go gather up some levels to rename them. This one means hidden hoof or hairy hoof. So I kind of like it, Fallhoofnar. So I'm going to use that, but I have to get some levels first. Alright, good thing it was nighttime out. I was able to go and hunt down some mobs and gain those extra levels. So let's go ahead and take the name. And there we go. And boom. There we go. Now we have our Fallhoofnar. Come here, horse. There we go. I was going to use Slifnir, but that means fleet foot or swift foot, but it also refers to a gray horse. So perhaps when I find myself a gray horse, I will use that name. And we'll have a collection of Norse mythological horses. I like that idea. Alright, well, we're back at the cabin in the woods because it's, well, supper time. I'm going to wrap the episode up here. I did find a little recipe that I want to try. It's not overly special. We're going to make use of this honey that we've been getting. And I like the sound of the ginger chicken. The other use, there is only two uses for honey. That's the cake, the ginger chicken, and the honey lemon lamb. Sorry. And I think we made honey lemon lamb already. Or have we? That sounds familiar. And apparently you can turn it into sugar as well. So I don't need sugar right now, I have other sources. So the ginger chicken just sounds good. I've gone ahead and collected the recipe for that. I just have to grab myself the pot, or saucepan I should say. So we'll take that. And in the saucepan we'll throw some honey and ginger, some scallions, toss it all up with the raw chicken. Bang, there's our ginger chicken. Oop, throw a pot on the floor. I'm a messy cook. And we'll throw that back up on the shelf. So I'm down 7. Let's see where we get. Oh! Lovely! That's 6 full hunger. Well, cooking the chicken would have given me 4. So, yeah. Actually, that's a really good, and cheap too, really. I mean, the honey's easy to get. I think, do I have some pressing here? No, just the wax. Honey's easy to get. And scallions are growing up on the garden. Raw chicken isn't too hard to come by. Ginger comes out of the herb gardens here. And I have them growing. See, this is where you get your honey. You get yourself a queen bee, and they start making honeycombs and wax combs. Allows you to make candles and get your honey going there. Ginger comes out of these, your herb gardens. So that actually is pretty good. I like that. Well, that wraps it up, I guess. We did some work today, I guess. I liked what we came up with. We will come back, and next episode, I have some ideas for next episode, actually, so don't worry. Hopefully it won't be too rambling, won't be too wandering, but we'll get some things done. Well, I'm glad you guys are sticking with me, and we will see you next time. Take it easy.